Hello everyone, we are from EQ International Magazine, India's leading solar energy magazine in the market. And today we have with us Mr. Siddharth Malik from MEGAWATT Solutions. Hello sir.
Hi, how are you?
I'm good. First of all, sir, I would just like to have a brief introduction about your company, MEGAWATT Solutions, and what product offerings does it have for the Indian solar market?
So MEGAWATT Solutions is a six-year-old technology and solutions company. We are headquartered out of New Delhi with the applications and service business centers all across the country. We have two primary verticals. One is solar heating and one is solar power. Across the solar heating segment, we provide concentrated solar thermal heating system for industrial process heating to reduce the fuel consumption. Across the power vertical, we have packaged solar projects, solar products, solar trees, as well as solar trackers. Our utility scale trackers have been a global breakthrough in the market.
Trackers has been a very much talking point in the industry in the recent times, and it has been very much acceptable in the industry. What kind of efficiency does it come with the acceptance of tracker technology in the projects which are being installed in the India?
One of the pride moments of our company is we are 100% technology company and 100% indigenous. So all our technology solution components are sourced from India, which are proven for the Indian weather conditions. In terms of efficiency, our trackers, which is the mega track, generates anywhere up to 18 to 22% more than fixed conventional systems, depending on where you are in the country. All of this with 100% indigenous delivery, extremely low maintenance, and a reliability that has been proven across the field over years.
What kind of acceptability are you seeing for tracker technology in the industry, and is it only concentrated to grid scale projects, or rooftop project developers are also using tracker technology in the market?
Since we approach this entire industry from a solution standpoint, we have trackers that integrated into installations as small as 5 kilowatts all the way to 100, 500, and of course megawatt scales to about 500,000 megawatts or so. So I don't believe there is any constraint in terms of sizes. On the contrary, we see a lot of traction from the market for trackers, even in 100 kilowatt sizes, all the way to, of course, utility scale as well, where we're extremely active.
What about the acceptability? Are project developers very much open to accept the tracker technology? Is cost still a consideration in their calculations?
Well, given the recent trend in prices, the tariffs, the bids, and it has of course been extremely competitive, and add to that the constrained land which is being made available to developers, the emphasis on generation has never been like this before. So the emphasis on generation directly yields interest in tracker technology by developers. We have received a tremendous response with more than 40 megawatts in place on ground, simply because our trackers are proven, they're very robust, they're 100% indigenous, and economically, they create a value proposition whereby a fractional of investment allows you to generate up to 18 to 22% higher. So it's a no-brainer.
That's great. And since you have brought low tariffs in the discussion, I would just like to have some comments on the recent Rewa bid which happened, which saw means record time low levels, and it was such a mega project which needs to be installed. What are your comments on that? How is it going to change the industry? How is it going to change the 100 gigawatt target which the government has set?
Well, I think the Rewa bid, of course, has been the talk of the world, what India has done to tariffs. At the same time, for the larger industry, it's very beneficial because it sends a very strong signal out on how committed we are as a nation towards solar energy and making it economically competitive with fossil fuels. Of course, these are tariffs on paper. They are being driven by a lot of assumptions based on system prices, module prices, and other terms and conditions of the contract. It remains to be seen on the economical viability of these tariffs being in place and people being able to kind of make the kind of money that they think they'll be able to. So I think the stage is set for a very competitive solar industry. Time will tell in terms of the overall viability of these tariffs to be able to make enough money. Thank you for the interview.
Thanks.